I've been learning a new software for a project I've been working on, and it's reminded me how important it is to understand the basics of a program to effectively use the tools. I started diving in, figuring I could just figure it out, and all I did was give myself a week-long headache. But then, once I started learning how the tools and the program actually functioned, what I was trying to create became so much easier. So today, I want to talk to you about two things that really confused me when I was starting to learn Clo3d. But when I finally learned how they worked and how they functioned, I was able to create so much more easily. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I talk about digital fashion design, software, and communication on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. If you've been learning about Clo, 3D fashion design software, and you've been kind of dabbling in it, you may have heard people talk about mesh and particle distance. We had a week-long crash course at FIT, and I heard those terms multiple times, but I never quite understood what they meant. And I don't know if the trainers didn't stress it enough, or perhaps I didn't realize it at the time, but they're pretty important. Not only do they affect how your final 3D rendering looks, but also how efficiently the program functions. Mesh is used in any type of 3D modeling. There are different types of mesh, but in Clo3d, you'll see triangular mesh because it allows for softer curves, whether that be the drape of the fabric falling from the garment or the drape of the fabric onto the human form. Because everything in 3D is made of mesh, it can potentially pass through another object. And you see this sometimes when garments collide with each other or with the body of the avatar. It'll usually look like one part of the garment is bleeding through another garment or bleeding through the avatar. In Clo, you can switch to the mesh view so you can see what it looks like, and depending on the particle distance, the mesh will look more open or more closed. Particle distance is the space between the lines of mesh. The higher the particle distance, the wider and more open the mesh is, the stiffer the fabric appears, and the more likely you are to have collisions. The lower the particle distance, the finer the mesh will be, and the softer, drapier, and more realistic the material will appear, and the less likely you are to have the avatar or other garments bleeding or colliding. This picture from the Clo website does a great job of demonstrating this. The top on the left has a particle distance of 50, which is pretty high. Notice there are wider spaces within the mesh, and the top overall appears a lot stiffer and more structured. Whereas if you look at the top on the right, the particle distance is set to 5. The mesh is very fine. It almost looks like there's no spacing at all within the mesh, and you can see some softer drape and fold showing in the top. So if that's the case, you might think to yourself, okay, so I should keep the particle distance low, right? Nope. You knew it couldn't be that easy. Remember when I mentioned earlier that the mesh and the particle distance affect how efficiently the program functions? Well, when the particle distance is low, your computer processor has to work harder to understand and calculate all of the mesh information to create that beautiful drape. This is usually when the fan on your computer comes on. Your computer is like, "Whew, child, I'm working hard. I'm getting hot." It also results in your computer moving much more slowly. You'll notice that simulation is slower, and just trying to move something small goes really slowly and takes much more time than it normally would. So it's recommended that you don't change the particle distance to high until you're ready to do your final render. And as a compromise, keep the particle distance around 20, which is the default for Clo3d. And it's high enough to keep your computer working efficiently without a lot of frequent simulation delays, and low enough that the fabric drapes relatively well on your avatar. And here's a quick pro tip. For smaller or thinner pattern pieces, like, say, a collar stand, maybe even the collar or binding, you can set the particle distance to a lower number to avoid collisions. And because those pieces are so small, it won't affect the speed of the simulation. So I hope that not only helps you better understand why people keep talking about the mesh and the particle distance, but if you're someone whose computer has been moving painfully slow as you've been working, perhaps adjusting the particle distance will make it move a little faster. And for those of you who aren't familiar with where to change the particle distance, you'd select the pattern piece you want to change and you go into the property editor, scroll down to simulation properties, and the first option allows you to change the particle distance. Thanks for watching today's video. If you want to start learning Clo3d with a clear, simple workflow to get you started, tap the link in the description to sign up for my beginner Clo3d class. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.